Top 10 set, and this morning we know who's in contention for the big prize of $250,000. We brought you the announcement of the top 10 live last night, right here on Wood TV 8. And now we're finding out what our choices say about the third year of the competition here. And I'm joined this morning by Caroline Older. She's the executive director for the Arts Council of Greater Grand Rapids to talk a little bit about this. So, first off, your thoughts on the top 10.
Well, I think it's interesting that we're seeing certain themes reoccur with the public vote. We're seeing almost a celebrity artist appear in Grand Rapids. And I say that because we have four artists, Tracy Van Dynen, Bill Secunda, Early in the Morning.
Yeah, Sunti.
Four that have appeared in the top 10 okay. in the past 2 years.
I see.
So artists are, the public is obviously drawn to those artists and their work, and they recognize it. So I think that's kind of interesting that these artists are gaining some name recognition in our area, and thus maybe that's helping, in addition to their work, them get on the top 10 list again. And then I think the other point that's kind of interesting, at least for me coming from an art history background, is that we're seeing the public be attracted to representational work, to work that they can identify with. So whether it's the dog or the crucifixion, it's work that is very accessible to them and identifiable. And sometimes in museums or galleries, you tend to see work, particularly when you're exhibiting contemporary work, that's pushing the boundaries, that's a bit more abstract. Mm-hmm. I think we do see that with Tempest and Rain, and I have to admit that I haven't seen either of those works in person, but in looking at them online, they remind me a little bit of Belly Lou's piece last year, Lure Wave, which were the red discs hanging. Aesthetically very beautiful, but with a message behind them. So a bit more abstract, and you're sort of getting the artist's message through the work.
In this case, then, the top 10 has a little bit of breadth here when you talk about whether it's abstract or it's something that's more representational of what you're used to seeing.
Exactly.
So we've got a good survey here of the arts to a certain degree.
Yes, I am happy to see the abstract mixed with the representational. But I think the one part of Art Prize that I find hard is that we identify the top 10 so early on. And I know that they have their reasons for doing that, needing to get the public vote. And I know everyone's going to go out and see those top 10,
right,
you know, in the next week and place that one crucial vote. But I do encourage all your viewers to also get out there and continue
see
to
see the rest
see,
of it. It's going to be out there. It'll stay out there
exactly,
the entire time
there's
here.
So great art.
So much you can just kind of soak all in.
Yes, exactly.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your time this morning.
Thank you for having me.